All right, so, ready?
Go ahead.
Okay. You said, let's see. Well, I wonder, for this natural theology, could you even give one piece of evidence that is not God of the Gaps argument or an argument from ignorance? The argument from ignorance is a fallacy where it says, like, well, I believe God made the Big Bang, and I say, I don't think so, and they go, well, can you disprove it? No. Okay, therefore my argument stands. Because we don't know, they're saying that's evidence for God. So can you give any kind of evidence that doesn't fall into something like that?
Well, but these authors are Christian philosophers. And what they're doing is they are giving a historic survey of natural theology. And what Anselm and Aquinas, back in the 11th and 12th centuries, what they pinpointed was this problem of infinity, infinite regress and first cause. And how do these two things go together? We think that these are relatively new ideas, but natural science is just simply digging up what philosophers have been identifying for centuries now.
Okay, so hold on a second. So yeah. That's basically God of the Gaps argument. We don't know. That's the mystery stuff. Nobody knows, even quantum mechanics, nobody knows what's in a black hole. We can't go beyond what they call the event horizon. This is all right. Theory stuff. There's nothing there.
It's not theory. This is what's going on, Bernie. All of us have to deal with, let's say natural scientists, have to deal with phenomenon and have to deal with inference and explanation. And for most of us, we convolute all of these things. But since those of us who are on the street, if we're street-level naturalists, atheists, or street-level Christians, we're mostly interested in explanations. That's why probably this book is going to be difficult for most of us, because it talks a lot about the phenomenon and the history of charting the phenomenon. But see, I think when you talk, I hear you convoluting phenomenon, inference, and explanations. If you can keep those three and see how it's really inescapable for us to deal with brute facts.
Well, I'm just asking, is there any evidence? Is there any evidence for God that's not God of the Gaps? What evidence is there for God?
Well, when you say God of the Gaps, I'm assuming that you're talking about the gap problem that philosophy talks about quite a bit. And the gap problem is every time we don't know what to do with the phenomena before us, then through inference, we try to fill in what we don't know, and then we offer to people an explanation. Now, this is what occurs in every field, not only in philosophy or theology. This happens in natural science. That's why I said in my opening presentation that it's not only a problem for theists, these gaps, what we do not know. It's truly a problem for the natural scientist. And that's why we get, from natural science today, so many explanations.
Well, is there any evidence, though? Is there any hard evidence for God? You know, beyond the philosophy, you know, the philosophical arguments for it, which I am considering are God of the Gaps because it's appealing to things that we don't know yet. Is there anything you can appeal to what we do know? Is there any evidence? The DNA record, for example, fossil record, anything. Is there any evidence for God? Has anybody demonstrated miracles can happen when they pray? You know, like Benny Hinn, he's a faker. He does crusades all the time. What evidence is there?
Yeah, so natural theology isn't providing you evidence. It is looking at phenomenon, it's making inferences, and it's giving explanations. This is what happens. We do not live in this two-dimensional world. We don't live in a petri dish. Natural scientists, biologists, any kind of a natural scientist sees a little bit of phenomenon,
okay,
makes inferences, and then offers explanations. It's inescapable.
Okay. So do I have more time?
Yep.